Yeah, this is really material for political junkies because, you know, as you know, there was this virtually uncontested Democratic primary in Michigan, but there are some fascinating numbers there. Hillary Clinton, of course, received the most votes. We know that. She was the only major candidate on the ballot. And remember, this was a contest where no delegates were awarded. In the last week, however, this is interesting, there was this big push for Democrats to cast a protest ballot for uncommitted. So instead of Hillary Clinton, you could vote uncommitted. And a lot of different groups involving Congressman John Conyers Jr. began running actually uncommitted vote, and others were actually campaigning door to door, believe it or not, on the phone at rallies, spreading this message. And it did create this sizable uncommitted vote, despite, I mean, people went out in half a foot of snow to vote uncommitted today in the Democratic primary. In fact, 40% of those who came out to vote actually cast ballots for uncommitted. But what's interesting is that's someone other than Hillary Clinton. So we asked the question, where might that vote have gone if all of those major Democratic candidates were on the ballot? Take a look at this. Our exit poll shows that if these Democratic voters have been able to vote for a full slate of candidates, 73%, almost three quarters, would have voted for Barack Obama, followed by just 17% for John Edwards. And another interesting thing we found, there was also a gender split in Michigan, a repeat essentially of what we saw in New Hampshire. Women picked Hillary Clinton over the uncommitted choice by a margin of 60% to 36%. And even with no one opposing Hillary Clinton, remember there was that uncommitted line, she was only able to get 50% of the male vote. The rest chose uncommitted. And we point out those numbers. I mean, it is sort of insider baseball, Keith, because we have a lot more primaries to go. And the gender split that exists since New Hampshire is very significant. If Barack Obama wants to win in these future primaries, he's going to have to improve his standing beyond younger women voters, because Hillary Clinton is winning those older women voters, and that's what will help her win these future primaries. Keith?
MSNBC's Nora O'Donnell with the exit polls. Thanks, Nora.
What to do to our country?
A lot of Democrats are concerned about that, as to whether you can win a general election. Again, this is New Hampshire. Who's most likely to win the general election? Again, they say Obama, by a margin of 44 to 35. Now, the Wall Street Journal and NBC News had a poll where we matched Clinton Huckabee, Obama Huckabee. And let me take you through that. Clinton is 46, Huckabee 44. Obama is 48, Huckabee's 32. And when you look at the independent voters, it's Clinton 35, Huckabee 46. Obama wins independents 40 to 35. Obama gets 20% of the Republican vote. Why is that? Why is there independence and Republican resistance to you?
This America Morning. I'm John Roberts.
And I'm Kieran Chetry. And we start with two stunning shifts in two new presidential polls that are out this morning. It is now a wide open race on both sides, according to the latest polling, on a national level, both after Iowa and New Hampshire. A new ABC News Washington Post survey has Senator Hillary Clinton still on top, but her dominance has disappeared. She's lost 11 points since December survey. Senator Barack Obama picked up 14. A 25-point swing in the poll since December. On the Republican side, all doubt is gone that Senator John McCain is for real. His win in New Hampshire helped him become the national frontrunner by 8 points, followed by Mike Huckabee and Mitt Romney. And Rudy Giuliani, at times was the national front runner, has now dropped all the way down to fourth in the national polling. His decision to concentrate on Super Tuesday, that cluster of many states that are going to be voting February 5th, may have cost him 10 points in the polls. Also, a New York Times CBS poll shows a staggering shift in momentum in favor of both John McCain and Barack Obama. On the Republican side, more than half the voters had a favorable opinion of John McCain, 20 points more than in December. For the Democrats, Barack Obama gaining fast. 35% of voters now say he has the best chance of winning, compared to just 14% last month. Senator Clinton lost 16 points, from a whopping 63% to now 47%.